It's known the Psak Din of the Alter Rebbe that every father is obligated to teach his son Kola Tera Kulo, and he explains what is Kola Tera Kulo, that is Tanakh, V'chol Halochas HaPsukei Shal Kola Tera, and all the Halochas Psukei of the entire Tera, im timing with the reasons. Gehein Hein Pirish Tayag Mitzvahs HaTera, because that's the explanation of the Tayag Mitzvahs of the Tera, V'dik Dukeyem, V'chol Pertayim, and all their details. And even though there's different opinions, and even the mitzvahs which are not noig achshav, and also to learn all the words of their sages, which they darshan on the psukim, which is the hagodas, shenemar kim shomer tishmun es kol mitzvah hazeis, v'dorshe chachomim shleitaymar lamadati halachas daily tamaloyim kol mitzvah. Lemoid halachis vaagodis umedrish, shehu a Talmud shemefarish time halachis shemishnais shemebraisis umekayrom. That is the Talmud, which explains all the reasons for all the halachis and mishnais and the braisis and their sources. Bedroshes habsukim shebetayro. Halachis en yehudu lehem droshes bepsukim, and the halachis that don't have any droshes in psukim heim kabbalah halach lemoish mesinai or misvore. Vakol nitten leMoshe miSinai, and all this was given to Moshe miSinai. So everybody is obligated to teach this to his son. And then he says later in the later prokim that somebody that his father didn't teach him, he is obligated to learn everything on his own. But, however, the Alter Rebbe goes on to say that there is a lav of shikhes hatoyo, and if you learn something and you forget it, so then you are over a law for forgetting if you don't chazer properly. And he gives a whole order how to chazer. So you should know kol ha-teira kulo. However, later he says that if there's a person that does not have a good memory and he doesn't remember everything that he learned, so adam kazeh she'achar she'enin yochel lilmud divrei Torah harbe, tzorich she'yeh kol limude belimud ha'de ma'aseh. Since he can't learn a lot of divrei Torah and chazer them so that he shouldn't forget it, so he is obligated to learn that his entire learning should be in limud hamevili de maise. Shein halachas atzriches v'chol odom leida isom lekayim mitzvahs kilchoslin, which those are the halachas that everybody has to learn in order to fulfill mitzvahs properly. V'leizorim ekoshel b'isurim chas v'sholim, and to be careful not to fall through with something that's prohibited chas v'sholim. V'hein dvorim she'evshel lishol tomid l'chochem hamoyre she'be'ir. And those are the things which are common practice, that you don't have the opportunity to always ask a rav, a moira, a roi in the city. Or you will not be able to ask because you don't know what to ask because you didn't learn the halachas. The hainu, what is that talking about? Roiv erichayim, the majority of Shulchan Aruch erichayim, kamat kule, almost in its entirety, Umiut Yeredeya, Umaat Be'Evan Ezer V'Chosh Mishpat, and a minority of Yeredeya, and a little bit of an Evan Ezer and Chosh Mishpat. Kol Halacha Brua B'Taima, that you have to learn every Halacha clearly with its reasoning. Ma Talmud Umeforshav, and the Talmud and the Meforshim, Kwe HaRosh or Beis Yosef, Lepochis. The Rosh or the Beis Yosef, at least, V'Lachzer Aleim Lo'elam, and to constantly go over that. And even somebody that has a good mind, that he can remember the entire Torah Shabbal Peh, so first and foremost, he has to learn the halachas which are necessary for Maisa, because they come before any other halachas which are not necessary for Maisa. V'limud ha'agodas maybe gamkin le de ma'isel is boinim etecha musar haskel k'moshin izbari le'maylo, and also limud ha'agodas which bring to Yerushimayim, they also are things which bring to ma'isa to learn from them the musar haskel as is explained. U'mishel lo yagia le'midazul lilmud b'sifir musar she'nivnu devrehim ala medroshim ha'agodas v'maymori ha'zayir. And if somebody can't learn the ha'agodas and understand from them the musar haskel, so he has to learn those for him that are built on Midrashim and Haggadahs and Maamarim Hazeir in order to get this. Bekol zeh mevat hakriya b'tanach le'itim mizumanim k'mo shenisbar l'mayla she'esh l'din k'dim al hakol. And this is besides the reading of Tanakh. And only after he is clearly baki in all the halachas l'maisa, that's when he should set aside a time to learn other things of Kol HaTorah Kulo. So this is, as far as the mitzvah of Talmud Torah is concerned, first and foremost, you have an obligation to know all the halachas with the reasoning, which are Negei L'maisa, as he explained that that's the majority of Eruch Chaim, and parts of Yeredeya, and also certain parts of Evan Ezra and Chesh Mishpat. Besides the obligation because of Hilchas Talmud Torah, there is another obligation that's written in Sforim that we say, Lilmoid Ulelamed Lishmer Velases, to learn, to teach, to keep, and to fulfill. Which means that every mitzvah has in it four parts. The learning of the mitzvahs, the teaching of the mitzvahs, the keeping of the mitzvahs to make sure that I know them and that I'm guarding myself from falling through, and the actual fulfillment of the mitzvahs. These are four integral parts. Just to do the mitzvah without knowing the halachas, I'm not fulfilling the mitzvah in totality. Then there is also what the Alter Rebbe brings in Hilchos Talmud Torah and in Tanya, that every single neshama comes down until it fulfills all tayag mitzvahs, machshava, dibur, emaisa. That the machshava and the dibur of all tayag mitzvahs, that is the learning about them, learning all the different halachas about them, and then the fulfillment of them. Those mitzvahs that nowadays we cannot fulfill, so in that we have the kol ha'esek b'teiras eila k'hilei kif eila. But even though that learning about these mitzvahs is as if we fulfill these mitzvahs, because the lack of fulfillment is not our fault. However, what we could do, we're obligated to do. And in this itself, like this is part of the Psak Din of the Alter Rebbe, the Din Gedime, what comes first is those halachas that I actually can fulfill and must fulfill, that I must know all the halachas of these so that I should fulfill them properly. In this itself, there are those things that the Alter Rebbe mentions in Tanya and in other places, and the Poiskim mentioned it, that without knowing the halachas, it's impossible to fulfill it. Like all the halachas of Shabbos, it's impossible to know all the halachas of Muktzeh, Beirur, etc., the Lamates Melachas, and not fall through if I don't know the exact halachas. The same thing is true also with tefillah. There's many digdukim in tefillah that people that are not didn't learn the halachas, even though they might go to a minyan, it's impossible to fulfill all the halachas of tefillah, where you're allowed to be mafsig, where you're not allowed to be mafsig, where you have to have kavana, where you have to have more simas leif to what you're doing. So it's impossible to fulfill them. The same thing is true with many, many more other mitzvahs, that without knowing the halachas, it's impossible to fulfill them properly. But besides that, that even if one already was hurgled to be able to do everything properly, part of the fulfillment of the mitzvah is learning the halachas of the mitzvah. And that's why it's very important for every person that he has to be baki, in the words of the Alter Rebbe, in the majority, Rubei Kekulei of Eruch Chaim, parts of Yeredeya, and parts of Evan Ezra and Chesh Mishpat. Even women that are potter from learning, the Alter Rebbe paskens in Hilchos Talmud Torah, gam anoshim chayovitz lilmeit halochis hatzriches lehem leido isom kumaydina nido vetvilo melicho v'isa yichut. They're obligated to learn all the halochis of nido, tvilo, melicho, the iser of yichut, ukiyetz behem, v'chol mitzvahs esei she'ein hazman gromo, and every mitzvahs esei which are not dependent on time, v'chol mitzvahs loisase shel ha'teiro, and every single prohibition of the teiro, v'shal divrei seifim emid rabbonon, she'ein mezuris behem k'moy anoshim, that they're obligated in it just like women, just like men. U'b'yameihem hayu ha'chochem derish hilchos ha'metzius v'regilus ha'tzichas l'chol odom leido isom, b'loshen she'mevinus ha'noshim ha'ratzim m'day Shabbos v'shabbatai. Once upon a time, there used to be droshes in which he used to give all these halachas. So basically, what we're covering is all the loisases, every mitzvah zeshe she'ein hazman gromo, all the halachas of nida, tvila, melicha, isa yichud, and anything similar of occurrences. So the Rebbe once said, halavai, men should be baki in all these halachas the way women are baki. And that if women are obligated to learn it, because without that they can't fulfill their obligations, so if koshkim v'kal v'chayim are men, which are not only mechuyiv in the action, and they're also mechuyiv in the mitzvahs esesh shazman groma, that they're obligated not only to fulfill them, but to learn the halachas in order to be able to fulfill it properly. And Hilchas Talmud Torah says that they're obligated to learn those halachas, and that has a din k'dima over all other parts of Torah. With learning halachas, Chazal promise us the kol ha'esek b'halachas b'chol yom muftach lo yishu ben olam haba. What that means, that ben olam haba, doesn't mean that necessarily that only after 120 that's when you'll get to olam haba. But what that means is that even your life over here in this world is connected with the spiritual realms. Without limud haTorah, without knowing the halachas of all the mitzvahs that we're obligated in, it's impossible to be connected with the spiritual aspects of our life, because it's only the Torah and mitzvahs that give us that connection to the Eibishter that we're supposed to have. Chassidus arouses the ur and neshama, nigla is mevarit the chumrius of the guf, and only both together can make a yid the way a yid is supposed to be. And if we'll give ourselves over totally to what we're supposed to, the way we're supposed to give ourselves over, then automatically we can be the chassidim the way the Rebbe wanted us to be, and we can ask for Mashiach, which the Rebbe explained that the concept of Mashiach is shleimus haTorah haMitzvah, that the only way we can have a concept of shleimus haTorah haMitzvah is by knowing the halachas which we have to fulfill, and in order to be able to fulfill them properly, and that way we can ask for Mashiach Ad Mosai in the proper way, to be zeichet to the Gula Shleima b'chakorev mamash.